Hello everyone, in this video we will cover the section 15.2. In this section we will take double integrals over general regions. If you remember the section 15.1, in the previous section we defined double integrals over a rectangle, namely x is between two numbers, the first independent variable is two numbers, and y is in between two numbers c and d. So the region will be a rectangle according to independent variables written here. Therefore, just we will take the iterated integral of f of two variables written here, f of xy dx dy or f of xy dy dx. Independent variables x and y are between two numbers, therefore the region will be a rectangle, and we define the double integral over a rectangle. So if we generalize this rectangle to any region, namely we want to take the double integral of a function of two variables over the region located here, for example this one, what is the double integral of a function of two variables over the region, let's say d, located here in the two-dimensional coordinate system x and y? So how can we take the double integral of a function of two variables over the region d? What is the way for finding the integral? So in the section 15.2 we will see the answer of this question. Namely, we want to be able to integrate a function of two variables not just over rectangles but also over regions D of more general shape, such as the one illustrated in this figure. What is the integral of, namely the double integral of a function of two variables over the region D? So a plane region D generally is said to be of type 1 if it lies between the graphs of two continuous functions of x, namely if the first independent variable x is between a and b and the second independent variable y, namely we consider the function of two variables that is equal to f of xy, and we want to take the double integral of this function over the region d, which is type 1, such that x is between two numbers but y is between two functions of x. This is the difference from the previous section, namely the independent variables, both of them are between two numbers, but here now the second variable, independent variable, is between two functions of x. So this is called type 1, where g1 and g2 are continuous on the closed interval a to b, because a and b are the limit points of the first independent variable. Some examples of type 1 regions are shown in this figure. For example, d is between two continuous functions. If we consider the curves located here, g of 2 is the upper boundary of the region and g1 of x is the lower boundary of the region, and the left boundary is the vertical line x is equal to a, and the right boundary of the region is x is equal to b, you can see. And the second example, again the upper boundary is the function g2 of x, lower boundary is g1 of x, namely the region is between two functions of x. So how can we take the double integral of a function of two variables over these regions? Therefore, the double integral over the region type 1 can be evaluated as follows. If the function f that is equal to f of xy is continuous on a type 1 region D, such that D is given mathematically here, x is between two numbers, y is between two functions of x. So the double integral of f over the region D is written as f of xy, first we write dy because y is between two continuous functions. Therefore, the upper limit and lower limit of the inner integral will be the functions g1 and g2. The upper limit is g2, because g2 is the upper boundary of the region, and the lower boundary of the region is g1. Therefore, the lower limit of the integral is g1. And the outer integral is the integral with respect to x, such that the limit points of the integral are a and b, since x is between these numbers. Okay, this is the formula for finding the integral of a function of two variables over the region D, which is type 1. And the second type, which is type 2, considered as y is between two numbers, and now x is between two functions of y, okay? Where h1 and h2 are continuous functions. Two such regions are illustrated in this figure. Namely, we have curves for the left boundary and the right boundary of the region, but the upper boundary and lower boundary now are lines. You can see this is the difference between the previous one, because the left boundary and right boundary are lines here, but here left boundary and right boundary of the region are curves given by x is equal to h1y and x is equal to h2 of y. Okay, in this case we say this is the region type 2, and the double integral of the function f is found by writing f of xy dx dy. Namely, the order will be dx dy, since x is between two continuous functions. Therefore, the limit points of the inner integral will be the functions of y, and the outer integral will be with respect to y, and the limit points can be found by taking the limit points of the variable y. Okay, for example, we have two types for general regions. Type 1 is considered when y is between two functions, and type 2 is considered when x is between two functions. Okay, for example, evaluate the integral of the function x plus 2y where over the region D, where D is the region bounded by the parabolas y is equal to 2x squared and y is equal to 1 plus x squared. So the graphs of the parabolas given are given here. The upper curve is the parabola y is equal to 1 plus x squared, you can see, because when write 0 for x, y will be 1. Therefore, it is passing through 0 to 1, you can see. And y is equal to 2 x squared is passing through the origin, you can see, and the graphs will be in this form. So you can see clearly the upper boundary will be the parabola y is equal to 1 plus x squared, and the lower boundary will be y is equal to 2 x squared. And we can say the region is between two parabolas given here. And you can determine also the upper boundary and lower boundary by sketching a vertical line, blue one, you can see. And to find the end points of the variable x, we have to find the intersection points of the parabolas of the curves given in the example. To find the intersection points, we will get a common solution for the equations, namely y is equal to 2x squared and y is equal to 1 plus x squared. Therefore, we write 2 x squared is equal to 1 plus x squared. And writing this one to the left hand side, we get x squared is equal to 1. X squared is equal to 1. So x can be minus 1 or plus 1, x is equal to minus 1 states the left point, left end point of the variable x, and x is equal to plus 1 represents the right end point of the variable x. So we know x is between minus 1 and 1, x is between minus 1 and 1, and y is between the upper boundary is 1 plus x square, 1 plus x square, and the lower boundary is 2x square. So the double integral will be over the region D is equal to the limit point of the inner integral will be 2x square to 1 plus x square, and the limit points of the outer integral will be minus 1 and 1. The function is x plus 2y. According to the formula, the order will be, so this is type 1, you can see, because the second variable is between two functions, the region is type 1. According to type 1, the order of the double integral for the independent variables will be dy dx, and you can see from here also, first we write the limit points of the variable y, therefore the inner integral will be with respect to y, so we write dy, and the outer integral will be with respect to x, dy dx, and after computing this integral we can obtain the answer, you can see from here. So the integral will be equal to, the double integral will be equal to, first we take the integral of the function with respect to y, which means x is a constant here. What is the integral of 5, for example? This is equal to 5x. Similarly, the integral of x will be x times y, and the integral of 2y is equal to y square. And the limit points of the inner integral are written here. Writing these for the variable y, we obtain first x times 1 plus x squared plus 1 plus x squared to the power 2 minus, so we write the lower limit point of the integral, x times 2x squared minus 2x squared to the power 2 dx. You can see just we have a single integral with respect to x. This is very easy. After computing the integral from minus 1 to 1, we obtain the integral of the function is 32 over 50. Actually, this is the volume between the graph of function and the region, which is type 1. Okay, second example, let's find the volume of the solid that lies under the parabola z is equal to x square plus y square and above the region d in the xy plane bounded by the line y is equal to 2x and the parabola y is equal to x square. We don't have any rectangle for the region d, therefore we will use one of the formulas in this section. Namely, first we should determine the type of the region to find the volume of the solid, which is actually the double integral of the function, which is the paraboloid z is equal to x square plus y square above the region D. So when we sketch the graph of the given curves in the example, because the region D in the xy plane is bounded by the line y is equal to 2x and the parabola y is equal to x squared, the graph of the line y is equal to x is given here. It is passing through the origin, and the parabola y is equal to x squared, you know, has the graph in this form. Okay, this is the graph of the parabola. And we know actually this is the, this can be considered as type 1 because we know the upper boundary of the region, which is the line, and the lower boundary will be the parabola y is equal to x square. Also you can check whether you can check which one is the upper boundary and which one is the lower boundary by writing some values for the variable x after finding the intersection points for the given lines. First let's find the intersection points. 2x is equal to x square. 2x is equal to x square. So from here we get x square minus 2x is equal to 0. So from here we have x times x minus 2 is equal to 0. So x can be 0 or x can be 2. So when we write 0 for x, we get the variable y is 0. Therefore the first intersection point is the origin, you can see. And the second is obtained by writing number 2 for the variable x in one of the equations written here. So we get 4 for both of them. Therefore, the second point has the components 2, 4. And between these points, the upper boundary will be the line y is equal to 2x. For example, when we write 1 for x, we get 2 for the line, for the value, for the equation of the line, named y is equal to 2. But when we write 1 for x in the equation of the parabola, the value of the variable y is equal to 1. You can see 1 is less than 2, which means the upper boundary is the line and the lower boundary is the curve, which is the parabola given by y is equal to x squared. So after finding the intersection point, actually we find the left hand and right hand point of the variable x. X is between 0 and 2. X is between 0 and 2, and y is between the functions. The lower boundary is the parabola, so you write x square, and you can check, as I said, by writing any number between 0 and 2 for the variable x, and you will see the value of the function, which is the line, will be bigger than the value of the function, which is the parabola. Therefore, we write the lower boundary as the parabola x square and the upper boundary is the line, which is given by y is equal to 2x. So the double integral of the function, namely the volume of the solid, is equal to the double integral from x square to 2x from 0 to 2 of the function, which is the parabolaid x square plus y square, and according to the limit points of the integrals, first we write dy because the inner integral is the integral with respect to y dx, and also this is type 1, the region is type 1. Okay. So after finding the integral, we get the volume of the solid that lies under the parabolaid and the above the region. You can see the integral of x square with respect to y, namely x square is a constant, the integral of constant will be the constant times the variable. So we write x square times y plus the integral of y square is y to the power of 3 over 3 between x square and 2x. Dx, and x is between 0 and 2, and the outer integral is the integral with respect to x, you can see, according to this order, since the region is type 1. And after writing the limit points, we will get x squared times 2x plus 2x to the power 3 over 3 minus, so we write the lower limit, x squared times x squared minus x squared to the power 3 over 3. And after computing this single integral, we get the volume of the solid under the paraboloid that is equal to x squared plus y squared. And also you can consider the region written here as type 2. For example, let's sketch again the region here. So if we sketch a horizontal line, we can find actually the right boundary and the left boundary. The left boundary is the line y is equal to 2x. So since we change the variable x by sketching a horizontal line, you can see, namely, we will find the functions of y for the variable x, and the variable y will be between two numbers if we consider this region as type 2. So easily we can find the limit points of the variable y by looking at the intersection points. The lower boundary is 0 and the upper boundary will be 4. We look at the second component of the intersection points. And x is between two functions of y. To determine the lower limit and upper limit of the variable x, we will determine the left boundary and the right boundary of the region by sketching a horizontal line. You can see the left boundary is the line y is equal to 2x. So x should be a function of y. Therefore, we write x is equal to y over 2. So the left boundary is the line, therefore we write y over 2. And the right boundary is the parabola, y is equal to x squared. Y is equal to x squared. Therefore, when we find the variable x for this equation, we get, and we are in the positive region, therefore x will be square root of y here, because y is between two positive numbers, non-negative numbers. So x is equal to square root of y, therefore the upper boundary, namely the right boundary of the region, will be square root of y. When we sketch a horizontal line, you can see also the left boundary and the right boundary. Therefore now the double integral becomes, first we write the functions of y. The lower limit is y over 2, upper limit is square root of y for the inner integral, and y is between 0 and 4. Function is x squared plus y squared, x squared plus y squared. So x is between two functions of y, therefore the inner integral will be an integral with respect to x. Then we take the integral with respect to y. Now we consider the variable y as a constant, therefore the integral of x squared becomes x to the power 3 over 3. The integral of y squared is y squared times x between 1 over y over 2 and square root of y dy. Writing the limit points, we get y to the power 3 over 2 over 3 when we write square root of y for x, plus y squared times square root of y becomes y to the power of 5 over 2 minus, when we write y over 2, we get y to the power 3 over 2 and 4 minus y to the power 3 over 2. After computing this single integral with respect to y, we get the same result. So the region given in the example can be considered as type 1 or type 2. You can find the integral by saying that the region is type 1 or type 2. You can use one of them, because you can easily determine the left boundary and right boundary of the region, or the upper boundary and lower boundary easily. Therefore, we can use any of them. when we consider the types of the region. Another example, evaluate the double integral of the function x times y, f of xy is equal to x times y, where D is the region, capital D is the region bounded by the line y is equal to x minus 1 and the parabola y square is equal to 2x plus y, 2x plus y. The equation of the line is considered as a function of x, but here the equation of the parabola is considered as a function of y by eliminating the variable x. Actually, we find x is equal to y square minus 6 over 2, y square minus 6 over 2, okay? Or we can write y square over 2 minus 3. Okay, first we need to sketch the given curves in the example. So if we consider the equation of the parabola as a root function, writing y is equal to square root of 2x plus 6, you can see, or directly let's consider as a function of y as a parabola, x is equal to y square over 2 minus 3. So the graph of the parabola will be in this form. You can find first the y-intercept and x-intercept points, and also you can find the hill point of this parabola by using the formula, if you remember the high school. When write 0 for y, x will be minus 3, so it is passing through minus 3, 0, minus 3, 0. And when write 0 for x, so y square will be square root of will be 6, so y will be square root of 6 or minus square root of 6. You can see this is the point, has the components 0 square root of 6, and the coefficient of the variable y square is 1 over 2, which is a positive number, therefore the parabola will be upward, you can see, like this one, when we consider the coordinate axis according to the variable y. And we sketch the line y is equal to x minus 1. This is the this is the graph of the y is equal to x minus 1. So we will first find the intersection points of the curves by writing x is equal to y plus 1, you can see, and x is equal to 1 over 2 times y square minus 3. So from here we get actually 1 over 2 y square minus 6 is equal to y plus 1 minus 3, sorry, minus 3. So from here we have y square is equal to y plus 4 times 2, which means 2y plus 8, 2y plus 8. And from here we have actually y square minus 2y minus 8 is equal to 0. So from here we can obtain the factors of the left hand side will be y minus 4 and y plus 2 is equal to 0. So y can be 4, you can see the second component 4, and the variable y can be also minus 2, which is the second component of this point. So we obtain the intersection points writing 4 and minus 2 for the variable y in the equations of in the one of the equations written here, for example using this one, When write 4, we get 5, which gives the first component. When write minus 2, we get minus 1, which is the first component of this point. Okay. So from here we will determine the type of the region, which one is easy for the integral. When we sketch vertical lines, you see we have actually two separate double integrals because until this point the region will be bounded by the parabola the parabola 1 over 2 times y squared minus 3 and the vertical line x is equal to minus 1, and the second part of the region will be between the again parabola and the line y is equal to x minus 1. Therefore the integral will be not easy when we consider the region as type 1, because it is equal to the region will be we will have two types, we will have two parts for the region D. Therefore let's consider the second type of the region by sketching a horizontal line here. So here just we have the left boundary of the region and the right boundary of the region. The left boundary is the parabola and the right boundary is the line x is equal to y plus 1. Therefore we have just a double integral for the second one, but for the first one we will get two different double integrals according to the parts of the regions. For parts of the region we have two parts of the region when we consider this intersection point, because here the upper boundary and lower boundary will be the parabola by considering the negative side y is equal to minus square root of 2x plus 6 and positive side y is equal to square root of 2x plus 6. But and also the second part will be between the parabola with positive side and the line. So to make easier the calculation we choose the second one is to find easily. Therefore we write the double integral over the region D by considering this region as type 2, namely the left boundary x is between the equations of the parabola and the line. Therefore the left boundary will be the parabola, the right boundary will be the upper limit will be the line wise y plus 1 x times y dx dy, since x is between these functions of y and y is between minus 2 and 4, minus 2 and 4. Okay, so when we take the integral of this function with respect to x by considering the variable y as a constant, we get namely y is a constant. Therefore we just take the integral of x, which is x squared over 2, and writing the limit points we obtain this one, and then by computing the single integral with respect to y we obtain 36. So if we had expressed the region D as a type 1 using the first one, you can see, so we would have obtained the double integral like this one. You see we have addition of two separate double integrals, as I said, because we have two parts of the region, two parts of the region according to this intersection point, because before the intersection point the upper boundary and the lower boundary are the functions given here. After the intersection point we have different upper boundary and lower boundary. Therefore we have addition of two separate integrals, as you can see here. So this would have involved more work than the other method. Therefore when we choose the type of the region, you should look at which type is very easy for finding the double integer. Another example, let's find the volume of the tetrahedron bounded by the planes given here. Actually, when we have a shape in a solid in three-dimensional coordinate system bounded by the planes, so it is called a tetrahedron. So to find the volume of this solid, we consider the projection of this solid onto the xy plane to determine the region in the xy plane. So to determine the region in the xy plane, we consider the variable z first. So the plane x plus 2y plus z is equal to 2 intersects the xy plane, whose equation is z is equal to 0. The equation of the xy plane is z is equal to 0. And the line x plus 2y is equal to 2, because when we write 0 for the variable z, we get a line. You know, the intersection of the planes will be a line, and its equation is given here by finding the common solution for the planes. Z is equal to 0, and x plus 2y plus z is equal to 2. Therefore, the common solution of them will be x plus 2y is equal to 2. Okay, x plus 2y is equal to 2. Its graph will be in this form. And we see that the solid lies above the triangular region D in the xy plane bounded by the lines x is equal to 2y given in the example already, and the intersection of the planes, and x is equal to 0 given in the example. So the region bounded by the lines x is equal to 2y, x plus 2y is equal to 2, and x is equal to 0 will be a triangle. You can see when we sketch the graph of the lines, this is the graph of x plus 2y is equal to 2, and this is the graph of y is equal to x over 2. From here we get y is equal to x over 2, and we will find the intersection of them. So from here we have 2y is equal to 2 minus 2y, and from here we have 4y is equal to 2, and y is equal to 1 over 2. The second component is 1 over 2. Writing 1 over 2 in one of the equations of the lines, we get 1. So the intersection point has the components 1 over 2. And x is equal to 0 is the vertical line, you can see. So the region bounded by the lines will be this one. X is equal to 0, y is equal to x over 2, namely x is equal to 2y, and x plus 2y is equal to 2. Okay. So when we consider the region as type 1 by sketching a vertical line, we can see easily the upper boundary and lower boundary. Lower boundary is the line y is equal to x over 2. Upper boundary is y is equal to 1 over 1 minus x over 2 by eliminating the variable y here. So we can write the integral, the double integral. So we consider the plane x plus 2y plus z is equal to 2, which means actually z is equal to 2 minus x minus 2y. Therefore we take the integral of this function 2 minus x minus 2y, z is equal to f of xy. And the limit points of the inner integral will be functions of x, because y is between two lines and x is between 0 and 1, 0 and 1 according to the intersection point, you can see. And therefore the double integral will be in this form, which is the volume of the solid bounded by the planes given here. after computing this iterated integral, we can obtain the volume of the tetrahedron, which is equal to 1/3. Okay, the last question. Evaluate the iterated integral, already given the limit points, and the function is the composition of two functions, actually sine and y squared. Sine y squared dy dx. Okay, so when we try to evaluate the integral as it stands, we are faced with the task of first evaluating the integral sine y squared dy, but it is impossible to do so in infinite terms, since sine y squared dy is not an elementary function. Okay, we don't have a formula for finding sine y squared for finding its integral, so this integral will be impossible when we consider the elementary functions directly. Okay, therefore we need to change the order of the double integral to make easier the calculation to get a possible solution for the given integral, because in the current situation we have an integral of sine y squared which is impossible when we use the elementary functions. Maybe by finding the Taylor series of this function we can find its integral approximately, but we want to find exactly this iterated integral, we want to evaluate exactly this iterated integral. Therefore let's change the order of this integration. So how can we change the order of integration? So first we need to look at carefully the limit points of the double integral. From here we can understand y is between the functions of x when we consider the limit points of the inner integral. So x is between y is between x and 1. Okay, and x is between 0 and 1. So from here we have actually two lines, y is equal to x when we consider the first one, and y is equal to 1. When we sketch the graph of these lines, this is the graph of y is equal to x, you can see easily, you know, and y is equal to 1 is an horizontal line passing through the point 0 to 1, and x is between 0 and 1, and the common solution of them will be x is equal to 1, therefore the intersection point has the components 1 to 1. Okay, so the given integral has the order dy dx, which means the region is considered here as type 1, because y is between two functions of x actually. Therefore in order to change the order, we should consider the region D bounded by the lines as type 2 by sketching a horizontal line to find the left boundary and the right boundary. Okay, when we sketch a horizontal line, the left boundary of the region will be x is equal to 0, and the right boundary is again x is equal to y. When we consider the region as type 2, so we should find the variable x as a function of y, namely x is between 0 and y, which is the right boundary, and y is between here from 0 to 1, so therefore it is between 0 and 1. When we consider the region as type 2, you can determine easily by sketching a horizontal line. The left boundary is x is equal to 0 and the right boundary is x is equal to y, and the variable y is between two numbers for a type 2 region. Therefore, the double integral becomes now from 0 to y, from 0 to y, and from 0 to 1, which are the limit points with respect to y, sine y squared. Now we write dx dy, dx dy. So you can see sine y square is just a constant for the integral with respect to x, because we don't have any variable x for the function sine y square. Okay, y square is a constant, namely just we have actually sine phi, for example. Sine phi, what is the integral of constant? This is just equal to, namely integral of 5, for example, is equal to 5x, you know. Therefore, the integral of sine y square here is just x times sine y square from 0 to y. Writing the limit points, we obtain y times sine square, because it is equal to, by writing y and 0 for x, we get y times sine y square minus 0 times sine y square becomes 0. So just we have y times sine y squared from 0 to 1. So its integral is equal to, you can use the substitution rule, or you can see directly when we use the substitution rule, namely you should get a simple expression for the trigonometric function sine instead of y square. So let's write u for y square. So here du becomes 2y dy, and we have y times dy in the integration. You can see y times dy. Instead of y times dy, we write du over 2, du over 2, and we change the limit points according to the new variable. If y is 0, so u also is equal to 0 from here, from this equation. And if y is equal to 1, and u will be 1 also. And sine y square becomes sine u sine u, y times dy becomes du over 2, du over 2. So from here we have 1 over 2 times, what is the integral of sine, which is equal to minus cosine. So minus cosine, so we have 1 over 2 minus cosine. Instead of u, we write y square from 0 to 1, from 0 to 1, or directly you can use from 0 to 1. So from here we have 1 over 2 times 1 minus cosine 1. Thank you.